I haven't been saying the numbers recently. As you can see, I've been batch recording these, so that's going to be kind of a bitch to edit. But regardless, we're here to number 30, Little Shop of Horrors. Hi everyone, my name is Kyle. I'm currently counting down my 40 favorite films since I was born. You can go to the first video if you want to find out more about the how and why I'm doing that. I really need to make sure I say that in two syllables. Horrors. Little Shop of Horrors. If you know me in real life, you know that I adore musicals. Live musical theater is one of my favorite things to go and attend. Now, a lot of times, I have little nitpicks here and there, but the ones I love wholeheartedly. One of those is Little Shop of Horrors, which I can get into the differences between the stage musical versus the movie musical, but this is not a video for that. I just love this story. I do enjoy the fact that they got Ellen Green, who originated this role on Broadway, off-Broadway technically, and brought her into the film. For my money, there has never been a better Audrey than Ellen Green, and I think producers understood that. You need her in this role to really bring across that emotion, that trembling voice, that yearning that she wants to have something better than what she has. And then it's wrapped up in this goofy kind of like monster movie where a giant Venus flytrap convinces this nebbish guy, Rick Moranis, to go and feed it body parts. I'm telling you, fun for the whole family. The songs are great. This is some of the earliest work by Alan Menken and Howard Ashman, who would very soon after this be grabbed by Disney and be like, can you save our studio? And they were like, we guess. Frank Oz, who is the director of this movie, and many people would also know as the voice of Miss Piggy and Yoda, I think he was the perfect choice for this. He understands why puppets work, but he also understands how to frame everything in both the most comedic of ways and when to lean into the horror. Anyways, this is one of my favorite Broadway shows of all time, and it's one of my favorite movies of all time. But what are your thoughts? Let me know down in the comments below what are your favorite musicals, and what musicals do you want to see adapted next? Let me know down in the comments. Tomorrow, we're going to get into another film that is a little bit spooky, but a very different tone than this movie.
I know Seymour's the greatest, but I'm dating a semi-sadist.